I'm going to a very special bird hide. A friend of me tipped me about it. The hide is at a very quiet location and not many people visit this hide. I will show you the photos and videos in a future vlog. In today's video I will tell you a little bit about the different ways that I find new locations. Hopefully it's useful for you. And if you have any tips of your own, please do let them know by leaving a comment below. Let's go! Right, so how do I find my wildlife? You can imagine, I'm trying to make a weekly vlog. It's quite hard to make a weekly vlog if you do not have access to enough possibilities to make photos. Holy. So if you want to produce a weekly vlog, occasionally there is some pressure trying to get enough subjects that are interesting. But there are basically three ways that I find my location to photograph. You might know I have been involved in with conservation of several species, such as badger and otters, and so those are all locations that I know. And if you go out a lot, for example doing volunteering work, you will also find location. So there's a catalog that you build up in your head. You might also know I'm a professional tracker, so often when I go out, I also go out tracking. And while tracking, I see the tracks of animals, birds, and if there's anything that I think, oh, that's interesting, that also might lead to a location that is interesting to photograph. Someone asked me, do you have some kind of network with people that you hear? There's also a lot of tips involved. And that's also something that you build up over the years, because yeah, you will, if you do a lot of volunteering work, you also get to know landowners, you also get to know other people who are doing volunteering work and who have knowledge in their. People usually have something that they're very good in. So I'm very good at tracking, and back then, as the coordinator of a local badger conservation group, I knew a lot about the badgers and where the badgers were. So you exchange a little. So those are the three types of ways that I find my locations to photograph. And actually there's another way as well. I forgot all about that one, and that's just keeping an eye on the local news. I don't know how it is in your country, in your area, but occasionally in the Netherlands when there's something special sighted, like a beaver is suddenly popping up in the middle of a city park, if that's reported in the news, that's also a great source to find wildlife locations. Just one thing, guys, and this is something which is important. Just don't, out of the wild, go ask people that you don't even know about locations. I have a few people, when I know they know something cool, I can ask them. Those people, yeah, they do the same with me, and there's an equal sharing. Also, and that's also very important, I know that they will treat that information with all the care. And I also know that they will not share it to everyone. For me also, not everything always works out. But usually when something does not work out, I'm not making a vlog. So yeah, you guys do not see all the times that are not working out, because yeah, I simply not making a vlog of them, because if I'm asking your time, I value your time. If you are watching my vlog and you will be watching the entire vlog, and at the end there is no nice photo or anything, then yeah, then I don't want to make a vlog. Hope you liked the vlog. Do not forget to like the video and subscribe if you haven't already. And you can watch my next video up here. But see you over there.